and I'm presenting joint work with Heinrich Schulz and Axel Saalbach on continual learning for domain adaptation in chest X-ray classification. So nowadays, large chest X-ray image databases are available, which can be used to train deep learning-based classification models, and performance of those models is on par to radiologists. At the same time, it was observed that when training model on one data set and applying it to another one, severe performance degradations are to be expected. To give you a concrete example, we trained a DenseNet 1-to-1 on chest X-ray 14, applied it to Mimic 6R. For example, for the classes pneumothorax and cardiomegaly, the mean AOC volumes drop. This gives a key insight. So when you want to apply a model, you need some retraining on your target domain data. So the key reason for that is that the distributions of the source and target domain data differ, which is also known as the domain shift. We want to tackle this problem with techniques from continual learning. So continual learning addresses the problem of learning from a stream of data in a sequential fashion. So only small portions of the input training data related to one or another task are available at once. So we want to gradually extend the model knowledge, and we want to learn without catastrophic forgetting. In the medical context, this is very desirable because we want to preserve certain model characteristics, for example, due to regulatory constraints. So we chose regularization-based methods, a prior-focused one, EWC, and a data-focused one, LWF. So these both methods do not require any data from the source domain. No images have to be stored, no gradient information has to be stored, or any other information containing personal health information. Let's have a really brief look at EWC. So we have a classification loss related to the current task and a quadratic penalty, which penalizes deviation of the current model weight vector from the previous model weight vector. This matrix here is introduced so that the deviations are not penalized homogeneously across all different dimensions of the model weight space. So what we typically would like to want here is a Hessian matrix of the log likelihood loss. But since second derivatives are devious to compute, we chose an approximation, the empirical Fisher matrix, which can be computed only using first order information, which is available from the backpropagation anyway. LWF works a bit differently. So we compute soft targets using the model related from the previous task and applying it to the current task data. And here we add a regularization term. So we want that the current tasks model, the current model's predictions is somehow consistent with the predictions of the model related to the previous task. We conducted a thorough quantitative evaluation, benchmarking the classic joint training versus EWC and LWF. The setup here was we chose a DenseNet 1-to-1. Our source domain was chest X-ray 14. Our target domain was Mimic 6R. And so the first observation is that after adapting our model to the targeted domain, we could achieve good AOC values for any of those methods. So that means the new tasks can be learned. And now what is very interesting is to study the backward transfer. So the backward transfer provides a measure how good the model performs on the source domain after adapting to the target domain. A negative backward transfer is related to the effect of forgetting, whereas a positive backward transfer means that after the adaptation to the target domain, your performance on the source domain even increases. So here's the joint training with different portions of source domain data added to the target domain data. And we see when we increase the amount of source domain data, the backward transfer improves and even becomes positive. So combining both data sets, not surprisingly, yields the best performance. And here are now our continual learning methods, and LWF performed better than EWC. And what is really interesting for LWF, on average, we obtained a slightly positive backward transfer, even without any data from the source domain. This is a very interesting and nice result. And the performance is more or less comparable to joint training with 60% of the data. So to sum up, continual learning methods for medical image classifications are an interesting research topic, and they provide effective means in order to overcome performance degradations resulting from a domain shift. And so applying LWF on chest X314 and Mimic CXR even resulted in a positive backbit transfer on average. If you would like to learn about the details, please have a look at our paper. And yeah, enjoy the rest of the conference and bye-bye.